Hello. Well, you can probably get an idea from that intro clip what this video is going to be about. This is my DIY Mariam made from Xiaomi Yi and a Storm 32 gimbal and an Arduino and an nRF24 L01 module. And in here we have another nRF24 and a GPS and a barometer and another Arduino Pro Mini. So if you don't know what a Mariam does, by the way, then clearly you have not been watching enough RC related videos on YouTube, so go and watch some more. But basically the GPS location is being sent from here to this one, and it's using that location to point the camera, and the altitude is also used to get the pitch correct as well. Now, of course, this is nowhere near as good as a real Mariam because the real Mariam has very good image acquisition capabilities and binocular stereoscopic vision and very good framing of the subject and zooming and even real-time voice warnings to let you know about the quality of your picture.
Don't fly there, cannot see.
Okay.
So, of course, this little system is not going to be able to compete with that, but it turned out to do okay. And that's all right, I'm just going to leave it for now and dismantle everything and continue on with the bigger project because this GPS tag, I'll be using that for other things in the future. What I've done here is just a stepping stone to my long-term goal of having a follow me quadcopter. So this will be stuck on the quadcopter, looking down at this on the ground. So it'll be the other way around. But this was quite a good little test to just see how everything's working at this point. So anyway, you can see what's on here. Let's have a look at what is inside this, because this is all quite nicely packed in, if I say so myself. I actually took some photos as I put this together, and it's been quite a while now, so hopefully I haven't deleted them. But I might put some photos in here while I'm editing this just to show things a bit clearer. But you can see at the bottom or on the right there is a GPS module. I think that's only a 6, a Neo 6M. But I found out that it actually does 10 hertz update rates. So I'm not sure if actually I'm not sure which type of GPS module that is. But one thing that's important about it is that it's very shallow, or it's not very tall, so it fits in here quite nicely when you put the plastic case on. Plastic case, of course, is orange just in case it falls off somewhere and I need to find it in the grass. So it's powered by a 1S LiPo, a very small one, 280 milliamp hours, and underneath there we have it's stuck on with a bit of foam tape, but there's just a oh, there we go. So there's a 3.3 volt Arduino Pro Mini under there, and underneath this little bit of cotton wool, we have a MS5611 breakout board, and that's just stuck with some more foam tape to the nRF24 module. This is the one with the metal shielded case around it. So that's about all there is. Oh, and there's a cap on there. Actually, there's two caps on there. And there's a little switch here. So this switch number one, if I switch that on, we should see some little LEDs come on. And right now we can actually see the light from the GPS through the back, which is kind of handy because it lets you know if it starts flashing, then it's probably got a GPS fix. The other lights are a little bit harder to see. But that one at least lets you know that the power is on. Trouble is in the daylight, in the sunlight, it's very hard to see. So you really have to like shade it like that to see it. But That's better than nothing. So the cotton wool just goes on there to protect the barometer a little bit. And I'll show you some video, of course, of some testing that I did with this. And I found, to my surprise, well, shouldn't be too surprising because I had read that sunlight was a factor for barometers, or light in general, I guess. So I've put a little bit of black marker across here where the barometer is, but I don't think it made any difference. But I did notice that when I put my hand over it, or my thumb, just to sort of give it a little bit of darkness, it did affect the reading a little bit. So perhaps a proper dark casing around that would be a better thing in the long run. So anyway, oh, did I leave it on? I left it on, didn't I? There we go. I didn't want to leave it on. So what this does, when it starts up, it takes a few samples of the current pressure reading from the barometer and sets that as altitude zero. And then all it does after that is it sends its altitude and its GPS location to this one. And this one, when it starts up, will, the first GPS reading it gets, it will take that to be its position. So you have to put these together and then reset this Arduino, or well, power it up with this one next to it, so that the first GPS location it receives is going to be where it currently is. And for the location of this, I have to place this so that north is facing that way, or so that this way is facing north, rather. I can't place north, can I? So then it will know that when it sets its yaw and pitch both to zero, it should be pointing north and it should be level. And then after that, we just need to calculate the difference in angle and altitude from where this was when it started, or where this thinks it is, and where this currently tells that one that it is. And then we can adjust the pitch and the yaw of the motor. It can't go all the way around 360 degrees forever and ever. So I've made it go minus 180 degrees that way and positive 180 degrees that way. And if it needs to go any further, it will have to spin all the way around to get back there. So just imagine it's like your neck. You can't keep turning your neck around forever. You have to, you know, turn it back one way if you're looking at something that's going around behind you. So not really much else to look at. I don't know if I'll really show any source code for this. I'll give you links to the source code as it exists at the moment, but I don't think I can really be bothered to explain it. The sketch on here is pretty simple. You're just receiving the location and calculating some angles. The sketch on here is a little bit more involved because I'm dealing with the barometer and the GPS and everything as well. The GPS stuff is nothing that I haven't done already. But I did find, one of the annoying things that I found was that originally I had the GPS connections, so that's the RX and TX there. They were originally going to a couple of pins, just general I/O pins, like pin 7 and 8, I think, or something like that. And I was using software serial, but it was too slow. So I was only getting one or two packets per second sent to here if I was lucky. So I have to make the GPS connect to pins 0 and 1 to be using the hardware serial, which is a bit of a nuisance because that means I have to unsolder the RX pin every time I want to upload the sketch onto here. But hopefully this sketch is not going to have to be changed very much. So anyway, let's just have a look at some of the video that I got while I was testing. The first test I did was an altitude test only. Just I fixed the yaw to a constant angle and then just raised and lowered the GPS tag by hand. And I set the distance from the tag to the base to to 4 meters, which is approximately the distance from where I'm standing there. And then I tried it. I placed the base point in the middle of my back lawn, and I walked around and around the lawn, or ran around the lawn, and just checked, looking at it the whole time to see if it was pointing in the right position. And then after that, I tried sticking it onto my big quadcopter and flying it around like that so I could get some more altitude and distance without having to walk. And I could stay next to the camera and check that it was functioning properly. So I'm gonna maybe repeat myself a little bit, maybe repeat some of the things I've already said in this next segment. Sorry about that, but wasn't sure if I was gonna cover everything properly otherwise.
Okay, so the way we have to do this is switch this little thingy on, close that up. I should have 5 seconds to bring this up to this height. And I'm just going to hold it here for about 10 seconds, I suppose. And the point of this is so that the altitude, so that this thinks that zero altitude is this height. And I'm also letting the sun shine on it while it's doing that, because I don't know how much, well, what effect the sunlight has, but I'm assuming that if it's shining on it when it's zero, and then it shines on it when it's somewhere else, it'll still remain a valid calibration. So I'm really hoping that we're not going to get some rain. The weather's been really crazy. Wouldn't be surprised if it's raining in another 20 minutes from now. Anyway, that should be enough. I also noticed that this GPS seems to get a bit better readings after it's been running for a bit. So now I'm not concerned about the altitude anymore. I'm just trying to wait a little bit before the GPS, for the GPS to get a little bit better reading, hopefully. I don't know if it'll help, but it doesn't matter too much, because what we can do now, what we have to do now, is reset the Arduino. Oops, did that work? So I had this running already, and I just reset the Arduino. Doesn't seem to be working. Okay, I just sort of twiddled with the wires a little bit and it came right. Not sure which one was wrong, but seems to be working okay now. So you can see the camera is pointing at the quad over there. And so what I was trying to show you before is that you need to hold the tag right here, and then reset the Arduino so that the first GPS location that the tag sends to it will be this one, and then it will set its location to be here. And thereafter, every other location it receives after that will be from that one. So anyway, let's just take off and do a bit of flying. See how well it tracks this. And let's position hold there. It looks, that's about right, doesn't it? Yeah, that's good. Yeah, yep. Lovely. So one nice point about this area of ground is that we can actually go down below the level of this quite a bit, maybe 5 meters even downwards, and check that the tilt or the pitch is going to go down. So let's try that. So if I just put this here and it's not down enough, is it? Let's just see if I can, the wind is starting to come up now. See if we can make the camera tilt downwards. Right, that's about as low as I can go, really. Slightly tilting down, but not much. I think it tends to aim too high most of the time. So that could perhaps be fixed with a little bit of trimming, maybe. But that is about as low as I can go, really. So let's do a climb from that position and see how well it follows that. Yep, that looks good. Okay, stop. It's just holding there, yep. It's about 45 degrees or so, yep. So I guess I'll just fly around a little bit faster manually and see how well it tracks when it's moving. Because this is a tricky part, isn't it? Yeah, it doesn't do that so well. Hold on. So you can see by it's kind of giving up at sometimes there, isn't it? You just put it a little bit further away. That's not bad. So this house is actually exactly north the line of the house here, so that's what I just roughly aligned this with when I set it up. So that's the other thing you have to do. You have to put this, because I told it that it's going to be always facing north when it's at zero, I have to actually do that so that it gets it right. So anyway, I think it looks pretty good. Seems to be all right. Let's do a little bit more flying. Okay. Starting to get a little bit low battery this, and the I think it's going to be raining in 20 minutes, believe it or not, so that's going to do it for now.
So anyway, that's all the testing that I did that day. As you can see, I got cut off by the weather. It's been really strange lately here. It goes from raining to nice and sunny and back again within an hour, over and over and over. And I realize a lot of people probably wouldn't believe me. They think I'm exaggerating when I say that. But I took a time lapse of a couple of days ago. And I'll put a link to that in the description if you want to see exactly what it's like. Actually, it wasn't quite as bad as normal that day, but you can see a lot of transitions between sunny and raining very quickly. So anyway, check that out in the link in the description if you want to see that. But I'm talking about this, aren't I? What was I going to say about this now? I think we're done. Yeah. So I was just going to say thank you for watching and all that kind of stuff. But I did... Today was very nice weather, so I stuck this onto the top of this little guy, and I wasn't really expecting to have it to follow this at full speed, so I just cruised around at sort of a medium speed just to see how it worked out, and I'll just finish off the video by playing some footage from that. So it'll be sunny, at least, and no rain. So, yeah, that's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.